in the backfield. And Leinert checks the play at the line. Quick toss. Brian Johnson made a man miss. Brian Johnson to the end zone. Arizona! Touchdown!
Well, this kid could own Chicago if he can keep throwing touchdown passes.
Third and nine. They've run it one time. This is the ninth pass attempt of the first quarter. For Muhammad, it hung up in the air, intercepted by Aaron Francisco. And the second-year man out of BYU is still going. Francisco stays on his feet to the 26-yard line.
You'd have to believe that all this talk about the Chicago Bear defense, the dominance of the Chicago Bears, all that talk has gotten the Arizona Cardinal defense just a little riled up. Good pressure from Bertrand Berrien. He doesn't allow Rex to get comfortable, and then Francisco goes up and just takes it out of the air.
Do you think it's also
I'm sure to you as well.
Cardinals have not picked up a third and 11 or more all season. They have now. Anquan Boldin, touchdown, Arizona.
That's Matt Leinert leading him down the field again. That's going to be four.
First and 10, Grossman on play action. Trying to throw a lot. Intercepted! What is going on tonight? Gerald Hayes, the linebacker, picking up blocks. And Hayes takes it to the 29-yard line.
The offensive and defensive coordinators of the Arizona Cardinals look like they're standing in the huddles of the Bears. Wherever the receivers of the Bears go, you've got a defender standing there waiting. Gerald Hayes drops back. Now Rex Grossman tries to lead him. There's no way that receiver is going to be anywhere near open. He's trying to get it to Bernard Berrien, and if he doesn't get it, the corner covering him is
big bone. From the 40, Grossman, look out from behind. Almost lost the ball. Did lose the ball. And his helmet. Coming around the corner, Bertrand Berry knocked it free. Now who's got it at the bottom of the pile? Bizarre is the home crowd support for the Cardinals. Grossman pressure. He lost it again. Arizona's got it again. Chris Cooper came off the end and helped knock it free. Adrian Wilson in there as well.
This is an offensive line that is being embarrassed all for the first month of the season.
And they like him, and they do appreciate the fact that he played on a big stage in college.
Second half of the 15, he's hit from behind. Mark Anderson, the hit, the scoop and score for Mike Brown. The Bears get back in it.
Robert Griffin just told Matt Leinert, they're waiting for us to make a mistake. Now, this is not on Leinert. When you get hit from the blind side without anybody blocking you, when you get just absolutely unblocked, I mean, I have no earthly idea.
Coming off the corner, Antrell Roll is picked up. Grossman's pass is knocked down, and it is intercepted. Darnell Dockett comes away with the pick. As he continues down the field, no one has marked him down, and with a convoy of Cardinals, Dockett takes it all the way to the end zone. The Bears stopped. They thought the play was over. Ruling on the field, touchdown.
He landed on top of the Bear player. He did not land on the ground. Great presence of mind to keep on running.
Didn't Javon Walker do that a few years ago as well? Just catch a pass, not actually hit the ground, landed on top of one of the other players and kept running
on Monday night.
Like everyone else in this stadium, I thought he was down.
And they're going slow to set up the extra point to see if Lovie Smith is thinking about challenging here, with a challenge still at his disposal, and the red flag has been thrown. He rolls over, and his knee does come down there.
Down.
So he will be down. Rasheed Davis down. Takes him out, and once this knee hits.
This quarter has to be the longest quarter I've ever seen.
Chicago is challenging the ruling on the field that the runner was down by contact.
And he's right.
So it'll be at the 27-yard line, and it was such a... It looks very...
Chicago is uptight about Rex. His teammates were.
Throw. Great read. Picked off by Robert Griffith, the 13-year veteran.
He just absolutely refused to take underneath receivers. He kept trying to bite off.
Second down, here's James. Right into the line. Did the ball come out? It did. It is scooped up by the Bears. Charles Tillman takes it the distance, and Chicago is very much alive. You were saying?
That's exactly.
Remember?
How stupid could I possibly look?
Remember the one thing Robert Griffith said a few series ago to Matt Lehrer? They're waiting for us to make a mistake.
Well, there it was.
Watch Urlacher here, guys. Kept reaching in and just pulled it out of the arms of James, and it's scooped and scored by Tillman.
Denny Green's going to challenge the play. The flag's already out. It's a good decision to challenge it. Doesn't look like it's going to get overturned. Position, he has to just take what the defense is giving him.
Almost got to player's kick. Devin Hester from the 18. Reading box, Devin Hester into the open field. And Hester picks up another block. Devin Hester, the punter to beat. He beat him. Devin Hester, all the way. Touchdown, Chicago Bears.
This is just incredible.
That is exactly what he did in college at Miami to Louisville when they had a big lead. And the rookie does it again, 82 yards.
Absolutely incredible. They've scored no points on their own offense.
Hasn't missed from inside 50 this year.
Hester charges off the edge. The field goal is leaking. It's no good. He missed it to the left. And Rackers, a money kicker last year, for the second straight week misses one. Would have given him the overtime opportunity last week. Could have given him the win here. And the Chicago Bears are about to leave the desert with thievery. A 6-turnover, no offensive score win.
Leinart did everything that he was asked to do, including handoff on the last two plays. And then the Bears, Mike said this before, this would